A challenge can be done in two ways. You can either carefully formulate a plan to get maximum efficiency, or go on an infinity suicide mission where the goal is to grind until death. The approach I prefer is the former, as you can't really slap get good on a guide and call it a day. And also cause I suck at this game. Because of this, a good idea is not something that is hard to do, but something that is hard to solve. Getting a decent idea is a puzzle in itself. Too easy and the video is going to suck. Too hard and you're going to... To avoid this, I usually get an interesting mechanic and build my challenge around it. For finding interesting mechanics, you can use various sources, but mine usually looks like this.
Dear Mario, please...
Why are we still here? Just to suffer?
No, it actually looks like... So, you got yourself a challenge. Where do you start? Well, you can start by making things a bit specific. After that, you can break it down into little problems and solve them separately. This works best for linear things like a questline in Skyrim. So what about something non-linear, like a build guide for Dark Souls? Sure, you can break down Dark Souls with something linear like areas and bosses, but there are a lot of items and routes to choose from. This is where the bottom-up comes to play. You choose the best possible outcome you can get, and work your way backwards from there. But how do you know the optimal build before doing the run itself? You've got your standard wiki, which is most of what you need, but not very in-depth and sometimes downright wrong. You've got your special wikis, a lot of quality stuff, but mostly dedicated to speedruns. And you got your
illegal data,
which are the best because they are both scarce and unreliable at the same time. What you can do is gather a lot of information and verify them by trial and error. Also, I prefer to go a step further by uploading every 2 months and making them as shitty as possible. The software I use to record my video is OBS. It's free and it can do everything from recording gameplay to crashing your machine by The setting I use is CRF, which gives you the same quality throughout the record, with the only difference being file size. If you're doing a voiceover, make sure to separate the audio into different channels so you can edit them separately later. File sizes can be absolutely massive, so you'll need to invest in some hefty storage. After all the footage has been recorded, it's time for the cutting board. Piece of shit. My tool of choice is Vegas Pro. It's used by probably every Souls YouTuber that I know of. Start by dumping all the footage in one timeline. It fucking sucks. Scrub through and cut out the footage that you need. Use the plan you made to know what footage is important. Or just cut where the audio is loudest. Rearrange in the order that you want to present, and place markers on key parts for later. Don't worry about cutting too large or too little, because the next part is going to be...
It's only been 1 minute, and I already want to shoot myself.
Most of you say you want to be successful, but you don't want it bad. You just kind of want it.
Make a decision, and you go all in, and you say, I ain't quitting, Doc.
While my videos are first and foremost meme guides, having a story gives the video a strong emotional investment. And the major driving force of this structure is music.
I want to die.
After you find some banging tunes, choose the best music for the situation by using the markers. Don't worry about the length just yet. Focus on getting quality music. After that, it's time to... If you've survived the MLG days of YouTube, you'll know the satisfying snap of visuals matching the audio. Sure, syncing up the footage to the beat takes a lot of time, but it's totally worth it. Cut up the audio by listening to the beat. It's just like playing a rhythm game like Sekiro. After that, match one footage with one or two segments of the audio. If the audio is too long or too short, listen for repeating or similar segments. Add or subtract, depending on your situation. And match the end of the segment with the end of the music. While my edits are mostly subtitles and graphics, I try to do new things by plagiarizing other talented people's work. For beginners, I highly recommend watching the advanced tutorial by Terran. Or if you are a professional, keyframes with Bubsy series. With visual aids like cards, tables, and thumbnails, I use the widely used image editing tool called Microsoft PowerPoint. Speaking of image editing, I use Reshade to get a clean chroma key for thumbnails and edits. For productivity, I use Moonlight Game Stream to edit outdoors. And after all that, I render out the video for a final checkup. After finishing the first draft, I try to check it at least 3 times. First pass includes uploading to YouTube and watching it from start to finish. Working on the same video over and over can lead to missing obvious mistakes. It's a good idea to have another pair of eyes or a blank set of keycaps. After all the audios and visuals are fixed, I let it sit for a few days to check any copyright claims or demonetizations.